Greek playing card designer Lotrek has made a habit of creating some of the most uniquely beautiful, ornate, and sought-after decks in the industry. His limited edition designs generally all feature gorgeous artwork, fine quality paper, lavish tuck boxes, and often involve feats of printing that are unprecedented. His works can fetch quite a price on the aftermarket and are often labeled masterpieces by even the most discerning collectors. But even a master can sometimes make a mistake. Fortunately for a few lucky customers, Lotrek's mistakes present wonderful opportunities. This stunning work, the Arabesque Error Deck, is Lotrek's latest offering, or rather, almost was. Let me explain. Originally offered as a sight unseen pre-order by Lotrek's Oath playing cards, the Arabesque deck touted a steep $85 pre-order price tag against a post-release $100 cost. Still, thanks to his reputation for creating seminal works in the playing card realm, the deck sold out. Initial rendering and marketing copy eventually trickled out, promising gold and silver foiling, metallic inks, and bold colors. The Arabesque cards feature CYMK printing matched with two separate foil stampings, a process that requires three separate passes on just the faces of each card. The method includes precise registration, as any inconsistency or flaw would be glaringly obvious. Lotrek admits that only after many years of grueling experience in the process of printing did he even feel comfortable undertaking the combination of difficult techniques realized within this deck. In the end, he succeeded in overcoming all of those challenges, but ultimately was undermined by the simplest of oversights. Two of the cards had been printed with the incorrect index pips, the Three of Hearts with the diamond pips, and the Eight of Spades with the club pips. Look, this must have been a heartbreaking blow, and I can't imagine the sinking feeling that must have caved Lotrek's chest as he discovered his mistake. To make matters worse, the stock Lotrek used in the printing of the cards had been a limited supply and was now no longer available. There was no way to reprint only the misprinted cards. He'd have to start the arduous process all over again from square one. Still, Lotrek was quick to figure out a stopgap solution. Maybe he could sell these error decks at a discounted price to recoup some of the cost of having to reprint the deck all over again. And sell he did. Within 24 hours, Lotrek had sold all 100 error decks. To further create distinction between the error decks and the final decks to be printed later, Lotrek packaged the error decks in a slightly altered tuck case, featuring a slightly thinner cardstock than what folks had come to expect. Still, the tuck box features embossed gold foil. The front reads Arabesque in Arabic-inspired font with the words playing cards surrounding an intricately designed large spade pip. The entire design is surrounded with frames of more intricate line work. The sides read Collector's Edition and Heritage Series. The bottom features ad copy, the Oath playing card logo, and the handwritten edition numbering. Mine is number 3 of 100. The back of the tuck features an approximation of the back design of the cards, more intricately woven lines in the Islamic style, although the cards, as we'll see, are definitely more colorful. Obviously, the first feature that stands out is the shininess of the gold and silver foil stamped on the card backs. But behind the foil are swaths of red-orange and turquoise and black. The center of the design features architectural line work with floral scroll patterns and what looks like some Arabic writing. All of this is surrounded by a golden frame of more line work and poker-style border framing that further.
Via email, Lotrek told me that he'd always had a deep fascination with Arabic and Islamic art in general, but it was the illuminations of the 16th century Persian manuscripts, the type of work adorning the Alhambra Palace, that truly inspired this deck of cards. And nowhere is that more evident than on the faces of the cards.
This is a completely custom deck featuring unique pips and layout, as well as more gold and silver foil printing. Even the spot cards are lavish, subtly outlined pips within a gold field encased inside a foiled gold frame. The club pips are especially unique, with the center leaf having a pointed, elongated taper that feels very much in keeping with the motif.
The indices are the aforementioned Arabic-inspired font as well. Generally speaking, the indices don't offer the highest readability, especially the A's found on the aces, which can look like 4s at first glance, and the 3s, which could be mistaken for J's of the jacks. I'd say that if the deck had a single design misstep, it's probably this. The court cards, however, are what make this truly spectacular. They are arguably the most beautiful court cards I have ever seen. They most definitely look like they've been torn out of the pages of an ancient and luxurious Arabic text. The artwork is exquisite, and the foil only serves to highlight the amazing design. The figures themselves retain the feel of bicycle court cards, keeping the poses and the implements of their standard brethren. The crowns have been replaced with Arabic headdresses, the straight swords have been swapped out for scimitars, the gold foil excels in representing armor plating. The silver foil is especially convincing on the weapons. The King of Diamonds has an earring, the Queen of Diamonds holds a blood lily. I especially love that the Queen of Spades staff has been replaced with a Kamanche stringed instrument. I really can't say enough about how amazing these are. There are two jokers in the deck as well, alternately colored images of a man sitting on a Persian rug playing another stringed Arabic instrument, the oud. Both feature the word joker in Arabic style font. One joker mentions some additional ad copy and that the deck was produced in Greece. This deck is really one to be admired, and although you could play cards with them, there's a problem aside from the low readability of the indices. The handling isn't great. Truth is, the deck isn't a deck you'll find many cardists flourishing. In fact, it's very difficult to faro or fan these cards no matter how many attempts I made. Even springs were a bit tough to execute. The handling problems are almost assuredly a result of the complex foil printing technique, and for me, it's a price worth paying for such an impressive design. However, Lotrek has said that in the corrected reprint, which should ship soon, the handling will be in fact better. How much better remains to be seen. The truth is, my corrected copy of this deck will likely never leave the tuck box, as it's almost too beautiful to even shuffle. In the end, Arabesque is a masterwork of the highest order, even if the master craftsman behind it sometimes makes a slip up.
So you want to own this era deck or the corrected reprint? Well, I've got some bad news for you. You're likely going to have to hit eBay in search of them, and you're probably going to have to pay a hefty premium. So all I can do is wish you good luck. If you've watched this far, it means you enjoyed this review. Please remember to like and subscribe, and also hit that little bell down there to receive notifications whenever I post a new review. For now, I'm the Gentleman Wake. See you next time.